In the last video, we were talking about Janet, who was paying off a vacation loan to the bank. She was paying 2% of her principal every month in interest. And we saw over the course of 2 months that the amount of money she was paying in interest went down a little bit. And so the amount of that fixed payment that was used to pay off her principal was able to go up a little bit. So let's take a look at what happens over the rest of the life of the loan. So I'm going to go back to my spreadsheet here. So we've got at the end of month two, Janet owed $3,267. And so what we can see is we can just continue this pattern for the third month. So now, once again, her interest rate went down a little bit. The amount of money that's applied to the principal gets to go up a little bit. And so we can just keep on tracking this through the entire 24-month period of her loan. And we see that the interest paid starts out at $70. It goes down, goes down, goes down. At the last payment, she only owes $181. And so the interest paid is only 2% of that. So the amount of money that she's paying in interest is really decreasing over the life of her loan. And we could see that at the end of the 24th month, she overpaid by 4 cents. So really her last payment would probably be $185.01 to make that work out. Okay, so this sheet is something that's called an amortization schedule. Let me write that out there, amortization schedule. And that's just a really fancy way of saying this is what's happening over the life of your loan, how much money is going in interest, how much of it is principal repayment, and how is your principal changing over the life of the loan. Okay, let's take a look at one extra thing. Let's say that into the third month of the loan, Janet has her birthday and her grandmother gives her $200 in cash. Okay, so Janet can go out and party with this money, but you know what? She's starting to get a little buyer's remorse out of this loan that she's got. She's paying almost $200 a month for a vacation that she's already taken. Maybe the vacation was nice, but still that's taken a chunk of change out of her bank account every month, and she sees that happening for a long time. So let's say that she does this. At the end of month three, let's say that she goes to the bank with the $200 and she says, can I make an extra payment paying down this loan? And the bank says, absolutely, thank you for your money. And so here's how that changes. So at the end of the third month, how much of that $200 that she gave the bank gets to go to reducing the principal? And the answer is all of it. All right, so let me just put that right there. I will put in that plus 200. All right, so in that third month, she was able to pay down all of her principal. And so her new principal went down from 3267 to 2947 just in that 1 month because she was making that extra payment. And what happened to her interest in the next month? Let me go back and forth. So this is where she was before. Without making that payment, she would have paid $62.96 in interest the next month. With that extra payment, she's only paying $58. Does it make sense that it would be that much lower? Well, yeah, it does. Because remember, the interest paid is a percentage of the principal. And so the principal went down by a lot. And so the interest she pays is really reduced as a result of that. What happens if we scroll down to the bottom of this schedule? What do you think is going to happen at the end of the loan? Do you think it's going to end faster than it did before? And how much faster? So she paid off $200, so it's a little bit more than a single payment. Let's see what happens down at the end. Well, really, at the end of month 23, she really overpaid. She paid, if given her normal schedule of $185, she really only needed to pay about $69 out of that. And then the entire last month completely goes away. So what we can see is because she made that payment of $200, really, she saved herself $300 by making that $200 payment earlier. All right. So there are a couple different ways to think of that. Either she saved herself $300 or she shortened the loan by almost 2 months because of making that extra payment. So that gives you an idea of how valuable it can be to reduce the principal by making extra payments on a loan when you've got fixed terms. Is that something you always want to do? Sometimes people say yes. Some people really hate having loans, and you should repay them as quickly as you possibly can. If I were looking at this, I would say, wow, that's a 24% loan. That's a really expensive interest rate. You want that loan to get away as quickly as you can. I wouldn't make an extra payment on a mortgage myself, because if I've got that extra money, I really want to put that money into the stock market where it's making 6 or 8% interest, rather than paying it off against a loan where I'm only paying 3% interest. But that's a personal decision that you can make about repaying loans. All right, so I'm gonna have you do an activity where you're going to be, instead of using a spreadsheet, you're gonna be using a calculator on the internet, which calculates all of these things out for you, and then looking at that amortization schedule and realizing how that works. So enjoy that and think about that yourself as you're paying off loans in your life, about whether you should make advance payments on loans in order to shorten their life and reduce the amount of interest you have to spend over the life of the loan.